एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू स्पेक्ट्रम क्लासेस. दिस इज़ आवर पार्ट 7 वीडियो ऑन द टॉपिक मेटलर्जी. एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ मॉडरेटली एज वेल एज लेस रिएक्टिव मेटल्स फ्रॉम दियर ओर्स. दिस वीडियो इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर क्लास 10th, क्लास 12th स्टूडेंट्स. एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम द कॉम्पिटिटिव पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. सम क्वेश्चंस हैज बीन आस्क्ड प्रीवियसली इन द IIT JEE एंड नीट एग्जाम्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द वीडियो. So first, I will discuss the extraction of moderately reactive metals. And this chart, in the form of flow chart, we have also discussed in our previous video. I will give you the link of that video in the description box. As you know, the reactivity series, and as we are moving down the reactivity series, reactivity of the metal decreases. So here, I will give you the example of moderately reactive metals. So these zinc, iron, lead and copper are present in the mid of the reactivity series. And these metals are commonly found in the form of carbonate ores as well as in the form of sulfide ores. So let us discuss with the example of zinc. And here we are having zinc in the form of carbonate as well as in the form of zinc sulfide. So here you can see zinc carbonate is known as calamine as a ore, zinc sulfide, zinc blend as a ore. You just see here we are having oxygen, but here in case of zinc blend, no oxygen is there. For this zinc carbonate or calamine, we will go for calcination, and for this zinc sulfide, we will go for roasting. This I previously told you, and here again I will discuss you what is called calcination and what is called roasting. So calcination means heating of this ore below the melting point of zinc in the absence of air. So that is calcination. And here in case of zinc sulfide, since oxygen is not there, we are going to heat the ore below its melting point in the presence of air, so that in both the cases we will get metal oxide. And this metal oxide here in this case of moderately reactive metals, that will be reduced by either carbon or by aluminium. And in this case, we get impure metals, and that by purification gives us pure metals. Fine. So this reduction of these moderately reactive metals by carbon and aluminium, we are going to discuss here again. So first we will just see, this is concentrated ore of zinc metal, that is calamine, as well as zinc blend. We will go for calcination, and the reaction which is taking place over here. So this is zinc carbonate. This is in the form of solid, and on heating it gives us zinc oxide plus carbon dioxide, and here carbon dioxide is in the form of gas, so it is released. For zinc blend, we are going for roasting, and here the reaction, zinc sulfide on heating in the presence of oxygen will gives us zinc oxide plus sulfur dioxide. So this sulfur dioxide is in the form of gas, so this is released from there, and here zinc oxide is obtained. Now we get in both the cases zinc oxide. So here is your zinc oxide, and this zinc oxide on reduction with carbon or aluminium, we will get impure metal. So the reaction goes on, zinc oxide plus carbon, this will gives us zinc plus carbon monoxide. Reduction of metal oxides by carbon is given by the Allingham diagram. So that we will discuss in the next video, right? Here we are using the carbon, and carbon monoxide is also sometimes used. The reaction of zinc oxide with carbon monoxide is proceeds like this, zinc in the form of solid plus carbon dioxide, and here carbon dioxide is released, and in this way, this is, here is carbon and here is carbon monoxide. So here carbon and carbon monoxide works as reducing agents, and in this manner this zinc oxide which is obtained here is impure, and we will go for the purification of this zinc by purification of impure metals. Now reduction of metal oxide with aluminium powder also. Here I am going to show the reactions of metal oxide with aluminium powder. So manganese, chromium, cobalt, this is very important, and this is asked in the objective question, that manganese will reduce by carbon or by aluminium. So here the answer for manganese is aluminium. So this is very important actually from the objective point of view. Here you may have a question, why aluminium, why not carbon, as we did for zinc oxide. So the reason behind this is that in the reactivity series, manganese is placed above the carbon. So it can't be reduced by carbon, but it is placed below the aluminium. So aluminium is more reactive. That is why it is reduced by aluminium, not by carbon or carbon, right? So this is very important question and it is taken as an exception too. So here we will get in this way manganese and alumina, plus very high heat is released in this reaction. This is very exothermic reaction. So aluminium powder here works as a reducing agent. To initiate this or to ignite this aluminium, magnesium ribbon is used. And this reaction with aluminium with the metal oxides is known as thermite reaction. The reaction of a metal oxide to form metal by using aluminium powder as a reducing agent is called a thermite reaction or thermite process. In this process, large amount of heat is evolved, therefore metal is produced in the molten state. And this reaction is used for welding also, right? So thermite welding is very, very well known process. So this is the extraction of moderately reactive metal. First, we have to reach the oxide part of the metal and then we will go for the reduction part of this oxide, either by carbon, carbon monoxide or by other metals. So if we go with aluminium, then this reaction is known as thermite reaction. And if we are going with the carbon or carbon monoxide and with which we are to proceed our reaction, that will be decided by the Allingham diagram. The next is extraction of less reactive metals. In less reactive metals, we are having copper and mercury. Mercury sulfide, this is known as cinnabar, and copper sulfide, cuprous sulfide. Since we are not having oxygen in both the cases, so we will go with roasting for both the cases. So the reaction is this mercury sulfide. It is in the form of solid and this on reaction with oxygen gives us HGO in the solid form and sulfur dioxide is released in this reaction. Now we will go for the reduction process. So this mercury oxide, and here we are going to heat this mercury oxide, and this reduction is taking place only by heat. So this is called auto reduction process. We are not using carbon for less reactive metals. We are not using aluminium for less reactive metals. These metals are reduced by heat alone. So this is known as auto reduction process. And this mercury at room temperature is present in the liquid state. Now reduction of cuprous sulfide. Here again we are going for roasting. And the reaction is taking place. This is important reaction. So Cu2H in the solid form on reaction with oxygen will give us Cu2O plus 2 sulfur dioxide, and this Cu2O, this is partial oxidation, this cuprous sulfide, and this on further react with rest of the cuprous sulfide. So here this on reaction with Cu2H will give us copper in the solid form and sulfur dioxide is evolved. So this is important. So this is all about the extraction of highly reactive metals, moderately reactive metals and less reactive metals. In the next video, we are going to discuss the purification of these impure metals which we got by the reduction of metals. Thank you all. Thanks for watching.